I always say to my wife, these systems are like mistresses. They attract you in different ways, huh? Leave your reactor on its own on a separate table, so it forces you to keep a certain distance.
Right.
Good point. This is the way you have to work to safeguard yourself. This is the way you have to work to safeguard yourself. This is the way you... And then secondly, all your equipment around, most probably your ring pump, the pumps have a rubber ring in them for sealants, yeah? Very soon you're going to lose your rings because the field radiation will change the composition of the ring.
I see.
And then you find the life of your pump reduces by a factor of God knows how much. Instead of working for a year, you work for a few weeks.
Right.
I lost enough pumps and systems that I learned where my mistakes are.
Mm-hmm.
You have to always work your reactor remote with pipes. If you come into my lab, you see how I work. I make sure I'm always away from the reactor. Unless it's shut down, I go close.
Do you use a video camera or some sort of deal like that?
Sometimes. You see, this is like addiction. This is like you inject yourself with heroin, you go high, and you don't know what you're doing. The science and the knowledge is so absorbing that you forget the condition. You don't see the cliff, you just jump off it without you knowing. Yeah?
Yeah.
So you have to make sure the cliff is not high enough to kill you when you jump off it. So you have to put these systems, all your reactors, or anything you test, the smallest you test, always make it in isolation table, what I call isolation table. Yeah? That you create, you enforce physical separation to protect your own health. I learned that out of Tehran, because in Tehran, my reactors were 2 centimeters, 10 centimeters from me. Yeah? And then where I got hit is what was on my level, which was my liver and my pancreas. Yeah? So you have to walk away from this close monitoring. If you can make a table and increase your pipe. This pipe is too short. Soon you're going to find your pump will pack out. Because the energy released into the CH bond of your seals will open them up. They become like jelly. When you kick it out, you see it becomes, it's not elastic. It's not like a rubber hard. It becomes elastic like chewing gum. There is a lot of research about this. It's done by the Iranian head of space university. He's done this test for his PhD paper. So you looked at his research in Tehran, and you see these rapid condition releases will affect your seal. Then you see your pump doesn't work. You can't reach the vacuum you like to get.
Right.
Because as you saw the glow, you see part of the physicality of the glow. The rest of it is going in the pump.
Right.
Then, huh?
Yeah.
So you try to build
as much as... The first thing we said when we saw that is, this doesn't seem like a good thing.
No.
So
it is a good thing, but you can learn a lot of things from it. Your pressure cooker, use the pressure cooker, for example, to feed the gas in, to feed the gas out, and put a valve on either side. When you reach a high vacuum, you close your pump, and you keep the vacuum there, and you always vacuum in a different chamber and release in a different chamber. You have to.
Like a buffer, yeah? Basically.
So yeah. It's 2 buffers, yeah.
Yeah.
So you separate your chambers. One vacuum chamber should never be connected with the release chamber. Because the release chamber always, 100%, releases transition level magnetic field. Yeah, high energy fields, because it's very much, how can I explain it? You know, you like, you throw a jet of water in the air and you try to catch it. You can't catch all the water which is in there. You catch some of it. Yeah? When the plasma closes, it catches some of it. The rest of the water which is flying out, it becomes available into your system. So you don't want it to go back in your pump to damage your pump. You always vacuum in a separate chamber, and you always allow the chamber outside to be at least 10 or 15 minutes before you open it into atmosphere. Because it takes about that much for the transition energy to be absorbed by the structure of your container. These are little safety things you do. You protect your system, you protect yourself, and you have a very smooth running system. You enjoy playing with it, and then you see different structures. And if you can buy, like, the pressure cooker you have is fantastic, because if you use this as a outlet chamber, not the inlet chamber, mm-hmm. every now and then open it up and have a look what's inside it. You find new materials, you find new things.
Yeah?
Cool. It is very interesting, because I do that quite often myself.
Hopefully you won't find something more intelligent than we are in there. That's what we're worried about.
I'm doing that in my lab. They are interesting. I'm creating new life in our biological side. I'm creating new life in the lab because I have understood the structure of the creation in the universe. So I have created the condition where life started on Earth. And you see it. You see the proteins, initial proteins, are growing, and one of my sons was going through my lab and says, what animal is in there now? I said, okay.
Well, that's right. That's been a real eye-opener for me, too. I've gone through, 40 years of science and thinking and so on in the last decades, but I've never heard anyone claiming to know how to create life, let alone creating life. But you've laid it out in a very logical, more or less easy to understand method and way. And I thank you very much for enlightening me in that regard, as many things I've learned in the last few years from your writings and teachings and so on. So once again, thanks very much.
You're welcome. What is interesting, try to understand the condition which the material or the effect is created. Then you find you don't need to fight. It's very easy to do to replicate it. Understand the interaction of fields. Then you understand very easy how to replicate it. If you work in a matter level, you walk a hard path up.
Right. That's the way I'm understanding it now, is you have to think in different categories with this stuff.
No, you don't have to. You have to think the way universe works.
Correct.
I don't think God to spend that much time to create things. He just puts things in the place and it happens. It's nearly 8 o'clock. I've been online nearly 2 hours.
Yes.
I have a heavy day ahead of me. You're welcome. Mr. Ludmill.
Yes, thank you very much.
You're welcome. What I would like to do, if you want to do, we do the next session in your lab.
Okay, sure, yeah. We can do that.
Yeah? Yeah. And then next month we come back to Rick and see how far he's gone, or we work together in different ways.
Yeah, you gave some nice clues, Mr. Keshe. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, if you can put this on the net that people can learn from it, it'll be fantastic.
That's what I want to ask you, too, if we have full permission to be able to use any of this
tonight. This is the free... This is how we start teaching. We teach the world together at the same time.
And there's nothing that we said that you want to hold back on or anything. It's all public consumption.
If it is not, it's let them copy. That's the whole purpose. The more they copy, the safer we are.
Yeah, the whole copyright system is sick. Yeah.
Yeah. So send me the link. We put it on the forum as well.
I'll probably get several movies out of this as well for my YouTube channel. So, yep.
Nobody is wrong. This is the beauty of this technology. It doesn't mean you're doing anything wrong. You're doing it your way, and your way is as good as mine. But we have to understand each other's work and how we benefit from it, from each other's work. So on that morning, 2 or 3 hours we spend in evaluating what we learn and what we know from each other. And I'm sure we'll have a scientist from Poland who's very advanced in his reactor. He's joining me very soon in the Keshe Foundation lab to work with us because he's very advanced in development. So most probably you meet him in the presentation in the lab. Okay. I'm sure soon we have NASA scientists on our labs as well. They will come on board.
Right on. Great.
Well, I need to do some major changes in what I did to what we speak.
No, we learn from you the way you do it.
I will do some other stuff. I will get rid of this big chamber and make.
We're always changing things. It's never the same day twice. You must have the same problem too, Mr. Keshe, where you would like to have the same reactor twice, but you like to try a new experiment each time.
I always say to my wife, these systems are like mistresses. they attract you in different ways, huh? But these are safe, they don't cause you headache, they just give you illness. But you spend all your time thinking about them and working with them, and then you forget you have a wife.
Yeah, yes, and a life.
Yeah, and my wife says, at least I know in there is nobody else but you and your machine. I'm safe. So we play with it. We are all scientists. We do the way we like to participate and feedback. So in a couple of weeks we make a date and we do it in Ludmila's lab.
Right. Okay, sure. Yeah. We can do
that. Have a nice day. Thanks very much for all your time.
Thank you very much.
Have a great day. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye.
You're welcome. Bye, Desiree.
No, not
bye with
me. I have to talk with you.
I'll call you back on the separate line.
Yeah, okay.
Bye.
Thank you very much again.
Bye.
Bye to you, bird, too.
Wow! Yeah! Thank you.